Greetings, Bethel family. Today's devotional comes from Acts chapter 2, verses 25 through 36. For David says of him, I saw the Lord always in my presence, for he's at my right hand so that I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart was glad and my tongue exalted. Moreover, my flesh also will live in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor allow your Holy One to undergo decay. You've made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Brethren, I may confidently say to you regarding the patriarch David that both he died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. And so, because he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn to him with an oath to seat one of his descendants on his throne, he looked ahead and spoke of the resurrection of Christ, that he was neither abandoned to Hades, nor did his flesh suffer decay. This Jesus God raised up again, to which we are all witnesses. Therefore, having been exalted to the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he's poured forth this which you both see and hear. For it was not David who ascended into heaven, but he himself says, the Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. So here we have the Apostle Peter preaching a sermon here at the day of Pentecost, and we actually know the outcome of this sermon. 3,000 souls were added to their number that very day. For me, that's quite remarkable because we know Peter's history. We have a long account in the gospel of many of Peter's recorded failures, and I'm sure that's not all of the ones we have recorded. For one thing, we have the Peter who boldly confessed that Jesus was in fact the Christ, and then just a little over 8 days later, in that same week, he would completely misunderstand what was taking place on the Mount of Transfiguration when Jesus became transfigured before them. This is again the same Peter who had the boldness to get out of the boat that day and start walking on the water towards Jesus, but then soon doubt, and he became frightened, and he started to sink, and Jesus reached down to save him. So we also have Jesus predicting that Peter would deny him. And in fact, Peter did deny Jesus three times, actually. So we even have a recorded account in Matthew's gospel when Jesus said to Peter, get behind me, Satan, for you are a stumbling block to me. Your interests are not on God's, but on your own. So yes, we have recorded for us in the gospels many of Peter's failures, but that all it really goes to show is that apart from Christ, we can do nothing. We all bring our failures to the table. That's what we all have in common. But that's only a half truth, because through Christ, we can do all things. So while yes, it is true that we bring our failures to the table in Christ, nothing is impossible for us. So what was it that changed in Peter? Well, do you remember when the Lord predicted Peter's denial? He said something to Peter. He said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has demanded to sift you like wheat, but I've prayed for you that your faith will not fail. And when you have returned again, strengthen your brothers. Well, Peter did in fact turn again and after his denial. And what we see here is he's preaching on the day of Pentecost. Look at the end of verse 37. Peter and the rest of apostles, brethren, what shall we do? So the fact that Jesus sent him to strengthen his brothers, that's who he's speaking to now here, his brethren. So we do, again, have an answer to Jesus' prayer that Peter's faith would not fail. He would then strengthen his brothers once he turned. So we see the Lord's faithfulness to Peter, despite his denials and constant failures. And what we really see is that now the true working of the Spirit's power in Peter's life. He had power, and his actually the Lord's power had been perfected in all of Peter's weaknesses here. So that is as true for you and me as it was for Peter. So how do we exactly see the Lord's power perfected in Peter's weakness? Well, I think that's a fair question to ask. For one thing, there's a good argument that boldness was actually a weakness of Peter's before receiving the Holy Spirit, because he had boldness, but he lacked the wisdom and discernment to know how to step out in boldness. So the interesting thing to me is that Peter, although his constant mistakes, we see him perfectly expounding on the Old Testament scriptures to aid his argument. And this doesn't sound like the same old Peter to me. He's speaking boldly to his peers. He's not sugarcoating anything by any means. And as a result, we actually see the Lord's promise to Peter coming true here. Upon this rock, I will build my church. So if you belong to Christ, I just want to encourage you to be bold with the gospel, for we've not received a spirit of timidity, but one of power, love, and self-control. If you don't belong to Christ, or you don't know if you belong to Christ, I just want to encourage you right now, because it says something at the end here. Peter says to them, "Therefore, let all the house of Israel know for certain that God has made him, that is Jesus, both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." So according to Peter's sermon here, it is possible for us to know for certain that Jesus is both Lord and Savior. So I hope that day is for you today. All we have to do is acknowledge our sin before God, repent from our sin, turn away from that life and towards God. And I beg the Lord to do that work in you today. And since that's a work that Him only can do, I'm going to pray for Him to do that very thing in your life today. Lord, we thank you for Peter's example here, who's received power from you to proclaim your word to a people who desperately need it, Lord. And I just know that there's some listening today who do not yet know you. And I just want to pray for them, Father, that today you would grant them repentance, that they would return from their sin and give their life fully to you as both Lord and Savior of their life. And we thank you for your promise, Lord. Pray these things in Jesus' name. This is Pastor John at Bethel Baptist. Thank you for joining us today, and may God bless you as you go on your journey throughout the week.